Today we will explore how can we add cascading fields in a SharePoint list, which we can use in a quick edit mode as well. So cascading list mean if you have a country, you can select a country, then you select a province, then you select a city. So wherever you want hierarchical cascading field, how you can build into a SharePoint list. So, and without using any single code. So let me start with my demonstration. Here, this is a SharePoint list, and you can see if we will edit this into a grid view, this kind of the functionality we can add into the list. Like I can add this here, like this one. In the hierarchy, you can select. I have just put it an example of chart of accounts. So you might have a budget sheet, you might have an inventory sheet. You want to select a chart of accounts. This kind of chart of accounts you can select like this. So you can make as many as hierarchies in this field. So your user will be able to select from the hierarchy. As you have selected department, you want to select. So this is the functionality which we can add. I create a simple list. Test cascade field create. The list we are looking at it here. If you will insert any data in this list, you will press this edit in a grid view. So you can say my first entry. This way you can add. So it has been very challenging to make a cascading list, multiple fields having cascading effects. So we will do it with the term store management. First I will let you know how to add this column into it. So this is a manage metadata field you will add. I am highlighting it here, manage metadata. Press next. I have already created one manage metadata of chart of accounts. First I will add the fields. Then I will let you know how you can create your manage metadata. So from the manage metadata, in the manage metadata, you make a term set or terms. I will explain you later what are the term sets and the term. But as of now, you just select this. And the terms which is already been published into your SharePoint portal, you can see those terms. So these are the terms which you can use any one of these, like list of the universities. These are the terms we have made. Universities, their province, are they public or private? So this term you can use, and you can select from whichever hierarchy you want. If you will select this hierarchy, only this term will be, this structure will be available on your list. If you select the root one, this all structure under it will be available. So I am using, let's suppose I take this chart of accounts. Save. You can set some default value, some more options are there. You can allow them select multiple values from it, and you can set is it essential or not, that user must fill this field. As of now, I press the save and let's see what happens. It is saying chart of account are added. And now if I will edit this in a grid view, you can see this. I can add terms into it. User will be able to select this. My second entry. So you can have any hierarchy. I will let you know later on this video that how you can add these hierarchies. One thing, another interesting feature for this way of doing cascading fields, that you do not need to always navigate to the hierarchy. It is searchable as well. Like accounts payable, you want to select, you just write accounts, it will show you all the entries, accounts payable, account receivable. You can just select from your drop down. So it's a searchable as well. So this is the way you can add drop down, or in a cascading field, different hierarchies you can add on as many as column you can add into a list structure. So if the user is going to enter in a quick edit mode, they can use this hierarchy, and if they will be using adding new item from the new button, even then they can have this functionality available. I am entering my third entry in it, and you see that this is also available here. You see that third entry is also available. So this way it can be used between the forms and in a quick edit mode both sides. And it's a simple. Now I will let you know what is how you can add this your managed metadata and term sets. So in our next topic, now we will see how we can add these term sets in the taxonomy, and what are these term sets, what are these term sets are used for. So here, if you will check on the SharePoint site, when you will go there, you will go into a site settings, and you will, when you go into a site settings, you will go to a term store management. In a term store management, you will see this, which is called taxonomy, term store taxonomy. There are two types of the term stores. One is called global and one is called site level. So global term store, which are being made by your SharePoint site administrator, and it will be available to all the SharePoint sites in your organization. The site level terms group is basically made by you, and it will be available to your site and your sub-sites. So in the term store, if I will show you, you can create number of hierarchies of the tags. So primarily these tags and these hierarchies are designed to use with the document libraries. Just like you might have seen, you go to a Netflix, and with the tags you can search different kind of the movies. They tag different movies with their rating, they tag different with their type, with their region. So you can filter those things. So in the SharePoint for document libraries, these tags you can standardize across your organization, so that whenever somebody upload a document, for example, you can make the tags of contracts, type of the contracts, type of the agreements, and different, and people can upload a Word document, they can, from the tag, they can select this, what are these? These are contracts, or these are what? So primarily, these tagging terminology and the metadata is designed for the document libraries. But we are using it here for the list. In the list, we are using these tags to implement our cascading fields. So how you can make this? I have shown you that we have used this chart of account. So now, different I have made in the universities. You want people to select the universities and region. So I will show you how you can create this one. So here you want to create some of the taxonomy. Here you can say add term. you add the term here, say we can say regions. You have added this term, now you are adding into the term. So it is a sub term, you are in regions like Punjab. And if you add in this hierarchy, it will add under the region. If you add at this level, it will add under this hierarchy. In the scene, you can add Karachi. Karachi, you have to press enter. In the Punjab, you want to add. So as many as you can enter here. And when you will go there, you can select your this term where you want your user to select the cities. So if you have 10, 20 entries, you can make a list like this. But if you have more than 2000 and above entries, like I show you like here. So one by one entering it and creating a term set is a difficult work. So in my next video, I will be sharing with you how you can add a bulk chart of accounts or any of the hierarchy you want with the whichever level 1, 2, level 3, level 4 hierarchy, any field you can add into it. So in the next video, up till now, if you have any question, please share your comments and share your feedback with me. Thank you.